Good day, Minecraftians. Purple Mentat here, bringing you more Crash Landing. Last time, built myself an automated water production tree farm doohickey. Since then, through some comments on the video and just a little bit of independent thought, I've decided that I want to improve this system. But that's not going to happen today. Before that, I want to get a nice, stable, reliable source of emerald, diamond, and all of the other goodies that come from creating gravel and running it through a sieve. To do so, I'm going to be extending this inventory manager, the Steve's Factory manager that I have running my sieving operation. And I actually need one more inventory cable to do this the way, well, a couple more inventory cables to do this the way I would really like to, because I have a particular pattern for things that I enjoy and am going to keep using. Also, I'm going to want a large quantity of sticks. So we'll take what planks we have with us and actually what sticks we have and a pile of logs, just in case, as I'm likely to go through all of that. Okay, so to make this happen, I think I'm going to go like nya. The block gate goes here, and the autonomous activator goes here. We are going to set the autonomous activator to ignore redstone, and we're going to open up a port on the top of it for input. We also want the autonomous activator set to left click. Now, I have already dropped a barrel full of cobblestone onto the inventory cable. That is going to be necessary. And I'm a little worried. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think the rapid item valve will be able to collect the output. If it cannot, though, we will certainly add another one over here. All right. And I want one more barrel for those sticks I was talking about. And that's in my golden bag of holding. Get that set down and start getting sticks in there. I'm going to want all of the sticks. So, that'll do for the time being. All right, most of the rest of gravel production is going to come in the inventory manager itself, but before we get there, I actually want one more barrel. So, we're going to open up the inventory manager now, and I want to add another group, I think. Let me double check exactly how I want to do all of this. Yes. I'm going to want another group. And that group is going to be probably going to go right between, well, you know what? That group can be all on its own. Yeah, I don't need it to be attached to the primary pulse line at all. What I am going to need to do, is it in sieving? Dust excess. Yes. All right. We're going to rename dust excess into sieve excess. And we need to add this barrel to the sieve excess. And this barrel is at +211, -193. So let's get that going. Won't be very far. -194, -193. +211, -193. There we go. We're not actually going to want to add that right yet. We are going to set it. Oh, it doesn't have multiple containers selected, so I can't do that quite yet. However, we are also then going to change dust in to sieve in. And this, we can right away add that other barrel. 211, -193. And we will run command once per target. Fantastic. Now, I believe I have some variables set up, some of which will help with this. Yes, I do. There we go. Should have known that I'd have this ahead of time. -195 and -193. Good. Sieve output. going to the 3-block gates. That's fantastic. Right. So now we're going to set it up to use the sieve input and sieve output variables. So the sieve in inventories is actually going to, we want to deselect all. Yeah, so if you select all and then invert selection, you can easily deselect all. There's probably an easier way to do that. Show variables, I want sieve input. And for the output, should already be set to, it is not, but that's okay. It's an easy fix. It is now set to sieve output. Where are invert, deselect all? Oh, there's a deselect all button. Heh, whoops. And then I can turn off that gold chest. So everything's going to be going to that anyway. Check the variables, make absolutely, oh, whoops. I got my own stuff mixed up. Sieve output needs to be going just to that gold chest. And make sure the variables are set to not there. Good, 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 good. That's better. Right, valve in is where I want my sieve output. No, dust to gate is where I want my sieve output variable. I'm going to have to go rename that. And this is set to specify amount 1. And this should be sieve output, which is already selected. I just can't really see the selection box around it because it's so close to the same color. It all blends together. Wow. So that was a bit of a annoyance. There we go. And we're going to name this variable to sieve gate. There, that works. That works fine. So now if I have gravel in here, it will get basically added to the list of things that needs to be sieved. The more important one, though, is now going to be the new group that I'm going to create. As soon as I find the create group button. And this command group is going to be hammer time. Let's get in there. We're going to make our interval pulse trigger. It is going to input from our cobblestone barrel, which is at 211, negative 195. Hammer time. 211, negative 195. And also from, well, not right now. We don't need to do it from, it's the best way to manage this other bit. Probably actually going to be with the gold chest. Okay. We're going to input from those two spots, and you'll see why in a moment. Oh, we also need to input from the 211, negative 196, or negative 194. Which is our sticks. And I'm going to go sleep through the night real quick. The reason I need sticks is, of course, to make the hammers. There we go. So right after that input, we are going to make those hammers. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Waitlist is empty. That's because we're going to blacklist. Because it'll only grab the items that it can actually use further down the line. I believe, or at least that's what it seemed to do for me so far, which has been kind of fantastic. We're actually going to disable the trigger right away because we don't want it to be pulsing while we're just here doing stuff. Two cobblestone and two sticks. Excess inventory. Not really fully necessary, but if you don't set one, then that exclamation point doesn't go away. Now we need two outputs for now. There'll be more later. One of those outputs is going to be to the autonomous activator. And we're going to whitelist the stone hammer. Now, so far, all I've done is tell it to stock this guy with stone hammers. That happened very, very quickly, which is awesome. Output goes to the other output. And this one is where the magic happens. This is going to get set to the block gate, which is sitting at... Ow. I just got punched with the stone hammer. Be a little careful with that. 210, negative 191. Fantastic. Showing you the entire process of how this works. I'm sure some of you will absolutely hate this video. I'm honestly okay with that. And we're going to whitelist for here cobblestone and set a specified amount of 1. So now, this entire hammer time content, all it's going to do create gravel, which is going to get instantly picked up and shoved. It's actually not getting picked up. It is too far away. Okay, that's fine. We can now set this to high to temporarily disable the entire thing. Because I want to lock this barrel to gravel in any case. And I want to get myself... I actually think I can just move the rapid item valve that I have over to here. Yeah, that'll work. I'll have to reset everything that currently uses the rapid item valve. But the only thing that's currently using it, as far as I'm aware, is valve in. And that's targeting the rapid item valve. Okay. Simple enough. Put my rapid item valve right there. Oh, you know, it also potentially wasn't picking it up because this guy wasn't on. Yeah, about that. So, back to sieve, valve in, inventory, on my rapid item valve again. And, over on hammer time, we're just going to add an input to the inventory of the rapid item valve. It's going to work on all of them. Run command once per target. That's a little better. So, it's going to pick up everything from the rapid item valve. And, in hammer time, we're going to have an output here. Nope, we need one more output, actually. This is going to be for our gravel. You get gravel. And target inventory is going to be the better barrel at 193, was it? Too many better barrels. Negative 193, yes. Ninety-nine. They're mostly at negative 199. There we go. Or beyond. Now the thing should be happily creating gravel for me. All I need to do is set you back to redstone ignored. So it will slowly hammer that block, create gravel, pick up gravel, put gravel into barrel. It's not going to be a fast process by any means, but it'll happen basically all the time. If I want to be really clever about it, what I can do is I can add to the hammer time another output. This one keyed to the third block gate. And the item will be whitelisted to gravel with the number at 1. Because remember, it's pulling from, or it should be pulling from, the gravel chest already. It is not. But that's an easy fix. Change the hammer time input to also include the gravel barrel. Oh, you know what's happening? Because it's getting to the gravel barrel before it's getting back around. Yeah. So you need to make sure that your block gate output comes before your barrel output in the chain. Like so. And now we should see it slowly processing, which we do. It's a very slow, very passive system. Unfortunately, without this switch on, it doesn't actually have anywhere to put the excess from the rapid item valve, and I'm not sure I dare give it one. Anyway, let's turn it on, see how it all works. We are occasionally getting gravel in there. It's not a frequent thing by any means. And if I check in here, we are getting more broken ores showing up, which is fantastic. We're going to need to do something with those broken ores, though. They can't just sit there, can they? Nah, that wouldn't be fun. So I'm going to go build myself another autonomous activator. Once I have that together, I'll be back to show you what we're going to do with those broken ores. See you soon. Alrighty, quick refresher. Glass, seared brick, redstone gets us our servo. Servo, machine frame, chest, and tin ingot gets us our autonomous activator. So, bring this over here. You'll notice I have built the same three inventory cable structure. Going to stuff an autonomous activator there and do the exact same things with it. And we're going to stuff a block gate back there. And this thing's been running. It's been producing resources. Running low on dust, but that's okay. Still haven't found a single emerald. That's a little less okay. Fantastically, it seems to be keeping any gravel from spilling into this chest, even though it would potentially be possible. And this guy's filling up with ore dust, as is proper. So, I think I'm going to redo this whole thing, but that'll be later. This is kind of a work of love in a project that I'm having fun expanding bit by bit as I go. Where was I? Hammer time. Right. I'm going to need to first add to the crafting command, which means I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 18 more crafters. And I'll show you what two of them are going to do. And then I'll do the rest off camera so you don't have to watch me be really incredibly dull. Too late, some of you were saying. Well, oh well. Can't win them all. So I want broken iron in these four to create iron ore gravel. And the excess inventory is really not necessary in this case, because there will never be excess created. Okay, or... well, there. Nope, most of these don't have an excess inventory set. At least I don't believe they do. Wow, okay, that was a confusing interface. So there we go. And then also crafting. After broken comes pulverized? No, not pulverized. I need to look up iron ore. I need to sleep through the night before I get assaulted by spiders. Yeah. I hear what you're saying. Fix your wall. It's on the list. It's a very long list, and I will eventually get to all of it. Iron ore. Crushed. That's what's the next step. It's also crushed deep iron and crushed shadow iron because reasons. They are from the metallurgy mod. All right, crushed iron ore. Four of those. Creates for me iron ore sand. And these will both get just added right in to everything. And it's warning me, hey buddy, you don't have any excess inventory selected, but that's okay. Because it should be turning the broken iron ore into... oh, it has no target set for those things. So, output here is set to the gold chest and is set to the iron ore dusts. Well, now I need to add to that iron ore gravel, iron ore dead spider, Sure. That was fun. Items, iron ore gravel, and iron ore sand. And it has happily turned all of the broken iron ore I had into iron ore gravel. Well, ooh, I have emeralds and coal coming in. Good. Oh, and I had some gravel land in the wrong spot. No, maybe I didn't. That was a little odd. Anyway, emeralds and coal. I've been waiting for these. So emeralds are going to go in here. And coal's going to go up there. And that's all I need to do to make the emeralds and coal automatically sort into the proper spaces. I should never have any more emerald or coal showing up in that chest. Fancy, huh? Yeah, I actually built the sorting system to future-proof. And it's also expandable. It'll be very easy to add more to that later. That's a little weird. I'm not quite sure why it's doing that. I'll have to poke at the program and figure out. It must be inputting from here. That's the only thing I can imagine. Let's get that turned off. It's like glowstone, broken aluminum, and pulverized tin that somehow got stuck in the loop and was being right-clicked into those. Strange, strange, strange. I may have to move the sorting into its own process. In any case, I'll poke at that another time. Make sure it's working properly. For now, I guess it's just going to do weird stuff. And ultimately, I'm kind of okay with it being a little weird. Okay, so we need to add that autonomous activator, the second one, to hammer time. Specifically, the output, which has the whitelisted stone hammer. Simple as that. And now I have 9 stone hammers in here. Also, on hammer time, I want to add an output for one more thing. Create output. We'll put this here for now. The target inventory is going to be the very last block gate, which is at -190. That sounds about right. And the items are going to be whitelisted or gravel. I'm just going to set up all of the ore gravels. Aluminium, nickel, platinum, osmium, lead, silver, tin, copper, gold, and iron. Yeah, because zinc and then all the rest are metallurgy. Or there's cobalt and ardite, but I don't have access to those yet. We'll throw them in for good measure. I don't know if I'll actually be getting my hands on them, but we'll throw them in for good measure, just in case. All right, connect that to here, make it prettier. And it's placing down the iron ore gravel, smashing it, which is creating crushed iron ore, which is being turned into iron ore sand. Now, if I add to the same output all of the various ore sands, again, aluminium, nickel, platinum, lead, silver, tin, copper, gold, iron. You can already hear it placing. And then ardite and cobalt. There does not seem to be a cobalt ore sand. That is a little odd. In any case, it is now turning my broken ore into crushed ore, which it is then turning into ore sand, which it is then turning into pulverized ore, which is then turning into ore dust, which it is then tossing into this. I'm going to go set up the rest of the crafting, which I'm going to need 16 more for lead, silver, nickel, tin, etc., etc., etc. Back in a bit to show you the whole thing functional. Also, I'm going to do my best to track down that weirdness. See you soon. Alrighty, that was a bit of a chore, but it's all taken care of now. Let's go show you what I did. I ended up needing to build a bit of a cobblestone wall there to kind of contain things, as extra bits, as you can see, end up bouncing around a bit. Extra bits end up bouncing around a bit. This way they end up reflected back towards the item collector, which, or the item valve, which ends up collecting everything and life works out. I have the entire system set up now with all of the different crafters, which are turning everything into everything and outputting all of the ore, gravel, sand, and dust into the appropriate places. So now, ores are being produced pretty passively, pretty constantly, all of the time, without me needing to do much more than replenish that these two barrels every now and then. Now, I'm not getting any new redstone in, or any new glowstone or blaze powder. Those are the three things that I feel I'm really missing with this setup, so I'm definitely going to need to do something about those in the future. Yelloworium will be an issue if it turns out I need larger stores of power than I think I will, and I want to get into big reactors. In any case, for the time being, though, it's time to cook up what's in there. Get this guy running again with those 27 blocks of charcoal shouldn't be a problem. And I'm going to start tearing this thing apart between this episode and next, so that at the beginning of next episode, I can get this thing set up in a better, more efficient manner. What I'm really going to be working on next episode, though, is going to be building new machines, using up the rest of the cards that I have to do two things. One, to progress the thermal expansion tech path, and two, to try to progress the PneumaticCraft tech path. And I might run back into the city and pick up some more stuff from another building or two if that's what ends up being the best way to go. In any case, for today, I'm out of time, but I'm in a pretty good place for what I've accomplished today, as I'm now able to produce basically every resource on the map. And honestly, I do have the option of just gathering up another barrel full of dust, throwing it in here and turning the system on. The whole thing's been made kind of slow at the moment. In fact, I think I'll add these other two block gates to the hammer time output. Let's see. Inventories. Well, item, gravel, specify amount. This is the proper one. So we're going to add that block gate and that block gate to it. So that all, oops, and I also need to tell it to do, yes, inventories M, run command once per target. There we go. And now it'll move at triple the speed that it was. It'll actually quickly outpace the ability of this one to, well, I think it'll quickly outpace the ability of this guy to actually create the gravel. In any case, it's a nice, kind of slow, passive system that needs very little maintenance and will always produce more and more resources. And then every now and then I can just come over and turn it on and convert everything that it has in it into liquid metals, which I'm already set up to collect into their block form. I'm happy with this system. Oh, hello. I win. That was a close one. You know what I think I'll do? I think I'll finally set up a sink shell. I'm tired of having like a threat of death be a real thing. In any case, next time, more tech. No more Steve's Factory Manager for a while. Gonna leave that alone. I do have some more plans for it for the future, but it can wait. I'm sure you guys are sick of it after this episode. So yeah, thank you very much for joining me. I hope you have enjoyed this episode, and I will see you next time.